So dear students, the most of the students are asking about the remaining topics of programming in C and C++. So today we are going to start unit number 4. So structure and union and enumeration. So these are the three topics which we are going to discuss today. So the first concept I'm going to explain, what is structure. Okay, so before going to the video, please subscribe my channel Anu Computer Education. So I have already uploaded the important questions of programming in C and C++. So and unit 1, unit 2 explanation videos are also uploaded, so just can make use of those videos. So next directly I'm going to the concept. Okay, now I'm explaining what is structure. Okay, what is the meaning of structure? Important question, and you can expect this question in your final exam for 8 marks. Now we are going to discuss structure. So it is very important question. You can expect this question in your exam for 8 marks, as well as sometimes you may get this question in 2 marks also. Okay, so total you'll get the 10 marks if you learn this question. Okay, so what is the meaning of structure? If anyone is asking what is the meaning of structure, means a structure is a, okay, a structure is a user defined data type. Okay, user defined data type. A structure is a user defined data type. So right, already you know the data type answer, so that time I explained about the data type. So you know the in C language data types are classified into 4 categories: predefined data type, user defined data type, and derived data type. So now today we are going to discuss the user defined. So what is the definition of structure? A structure is a collection of, so this is the definition of a structure. A structure is a collection of storing dissimilar type of values. Okay, dissimilar type of values in a single variable is known as structure. This is the definition of the structure, is known as structure. So please remember, this is very important definition. So it means in one variable you are storing multiple values, and all these values are of different data type. So that is the beauty of structure. So what we are going to do, in order to create structure, we are using struct keyword. Which keyword you are using? Struct keyword we are using to create a structure. Okay, so these are the very important points you need to remember. So next I'm going to the syntax. You know, already just now I written the definition, now we are going to the syntax. How to create structure? You need to write structure name, okay, and followed by data type space member one semicolon. Next, data type space member two, and up to so on. We need to write here data type space member n. So like this we need to write. So after closing the bracket, you need to put the semicolon. This is a very important syntax you need to remember for the structure. I think the definition is clear to you. Okay, so what we are going to do here, we are going to create only one variable. In this one variable, we are going to store many values but all the values are of different data type. So that is the beauty of structure concept. I think most of the student the concept is not clear. So once if I go to the example, so you will come to know what I'm going to do in the with the help of structure. So now I'm going to explain here what is the meaning of structure name. Any valid name. So you can give any valid name you can give here. Okay, but here when you are giving the name to the structure, it cannot be a keyword. Okay, so apart from the keyword, you can use any name for the structure name. What is struct? Struct is a keyword, you know already. Sir, what is the meaning of data type? So here you use any predefined data type. Okay, here you can use any predefined. So it means what type of data you want to store, that data types, like you want to store integer, float, double, character, okay, character, double, or anything you can use here. So what these are, member one, member two, are nothing but these are the names, variable names. Okay, these are called as variables. Okay, now remember, this is over. I think up to here the concept is clear. Now next I'm going to the one simple example. I will be explaining with one simple concept. So now example, now I'll explain. So I want to store, my question is I want to store one student student information. So generally when I'm saying student, so store many details will be there for the student name will be there, first roll number will be there for the student, and name will be there for the student, and percentage will be there for the students, and so many details are there. So I'm not going that many number of details, just I'm going to take only this three examples I'm taking. Okay, so now I'm going to create one structure. I'm writing a struct. What is, which structure I'm creating? Student. So I want to store one student details now. So that is the reason I'm giving the name to the structure as student. Okay, so now generally what are the details which we are going to store for the student? Rule number. So generally rule number is of which type? Integer. So I'm writing here into rule number semicolon. So name can be stored with the help of string array. String array, how to declare string array, you know already, char name of 20. So it means you can store how many letters name? 20 letters name you can store. Okay, and next percentage is generally what? Decimal value, like 93.5 something will be there. So here you can write here float. Okay, float, here you write percentage. Now tell me, like this we can write many things, but in this how many are written? Only three details I'm taking. So rule number, so you tell me, when, what is the rule number? Is an integer variable. What is the size of the this rule number? 2 bytes. So character data type size is 1 byte. So to store one letter you need 1 byte, but how many letters you are storing here? 20 letters. So it means 1 into 20 is nothing but 20 bytes. So float variable is of how many bytes? 4 bytes. Okay, so count it, all the sizes you count it, 20 plus 2, 20 plus 2, 22, 22 plus 4, 26. So this is 26 bytes. Okay, it means whenever we create, so remember that some very very important points which I'm going to explain now. Whenever we create first I'll explain the memory size of a structure is equal to sum of the sizes of its members is nothing but the size. So sum of the members, so inside student, what is the structure we created? Student. How many members are there? 3 members. One is rule number, and one is name, and one is percentage. So add all these sizes, how many bytes are getting? 26. Now if anyone is asking what is the size of the student structure, means you need to say 26 bytes. Clear now? 26 bytes. So how you get 26? We have to add all the member sizes, and final figure will be your size of the structure. Now one important point you need to remember, whenever we create a structure, this structure will not get 26 bytes of memory. So example, so if you want to construct a building, so what you will do, you will make a plan. Now where you will do the plan? In paper. Now once the plan is ready in the paper, the building is not constructed. When the building will be exist in reality, when you get the raw material and really if you construct the building, then only you can see the building. Now so once you draw the building plan in paper, it doesn't mean that you created a building now. Okay, so just, it is a blueprint, that's it. So it means whenever we write a structure like this, the structure is not in reality now. So when it will be coming in reality? So it means whenever, this is important point, whenever we create a structure, structure will not get any memory space. Structure will not get any memory space until when it will get a memory space until we create a structure variable. This is important thing you need to remember, structure variable. So sir, what is the meaning of structure variable? That I am going to discuss in the next slide now. So this is a story you need to remember. So I created just now, I created a structure now. So how to create a structure variable? Syntax I am explaining. Which syntax I am explaining? Syntax for creating structure variable. So now what I will do here? So just I am creating the structure now. Just now how to create a syntax? Struct structure name followed by variable name. Okay, so I think it is clear. So example, so once if I write example, you'll get a clarity. What I will write here? Struct, what is the name of the structure? Student. If I write s, so what is s here? Variable. Which variable? Student variable. What is student here? Struct. So it means, can I say what is s here? Structure variable. What is s here? Structure variable. So clear, I think. So generally when I am writing here, int a, what is a? A is a variable. Of which variable? Integer variable. So here how many values we can store? Only one value we can store. That to which value? We can store only one value. That to only integer. Sir, what is s here? S is a structure variable. Which is structure variable? Student structure variable. So in s, what we can store? How many values we can store? Three values. But all the three values are, one is rule number you can store, and one you can store name you can store, and one you can store percentage. Now remember, rule number is integer, okay, name is a character, and percentage is a float. So all these three are same or different? All are of different data type values you are storing in one variable. So that is a definition of structure. Now I think the definition is clear to you. What is the meaning of structure? A structure is a collection of storing different values. How many values we are storing? Teen values store kar yahan pe. Ek rule number, ek name, ek percentage. Rule number integer hai, name character hai, aur percentage float hai. Ye teen different values aap ek variable mein store kar rahe. Usli aap un bol rahe, this is structure is a collection of storing dissimilar values in a single variable. So now you tell me, if I create a one variable int a, what is the size of the variable now? 2 bytes. Okay, 2 bytes. How you said? Because a is a variable of which type? Integer. What is the size of integer variable? 2 bytes. So what is s? S is a variable. Which variable? Structure variable. So what is the size of the structure variable? So integer ka kitna? 2. Character ka kitna likhe the wahan pe? 20. So float ka kitna? 4. Total kitna ho gaya? 26. So what is the size of this s variable now? 26 bytes. That is what you need to remember. Just now before slide I have explained the same point. Whenever, so this first point, the memory size of the structure is equal to the sum of the sizes of its members. So that is nothing but the size of the structure. So clear, I think up to here the everything is clear. So the same thing I am going to explain with a program. So once if I do the program, you'll get a clarity. Okay, so now what I am doing, so directly, so this is the exam time, so no need of going to the scanf concept. So simple program you can write. So just I am explaining one simple program here. So hash include, and one important thing you need to remember, one more last point I want to explain here. So last one important theory point, very important point, so you need to remember. So last point is, so in structure, okay, all the members, so I will explain this, all the members are having individual memory locations. This is very important. Okay sir, examples ksr bole to you created, what is s here? S is a variable of which variable? Student structure variable. So it means now this is what is happening. What is the name is which we are giving to this? S. And what is the size of this S variable? 26 bytes. So iske andar kya kya store kar rahe? 3 details store kar rahe. Okay, yahan pe ek rule number store kar rahe, iske andar name store kar rahe, iske andar percentage store kar rahe. 3 different details you are storing in one place. But now rule number is stored in integer data. So to store the rule number. So you tell me, what is the size of this location? 2 bytes only. And what is the name where we are storing? What is the size of the name box? 20 bytes. What is the percentage box size? Total size is 26. Okay, but rule number कहाँ पे store कर रहा? 2 bytes memory पे store कर रहा. Name कहाँ पे store करे? 20 bytes memory में store हो रहा. Percentage, अब जब percentage जब enter करते, percentage कहाँ पे जाके पड़ रहा? तो it means what? So every location, every member. So how many members are there? One is rule number, one is name, one is percentage. Everyone is having its own memory, but all are total is 26. Okay, but everyone is having their own memory locations are there. So when I'm entering rule number, the rule number will store in rule number place only. When I'm entering name, the name will store in name place only. When I'm entering the percentage will store in percentage only. So but all are sit together only. So samajh mein aana, samjho teen friends ke paas three different size ka bags hai. तो आप तीन फ्रेंड्स का ऐसा फ्रेंड्स है, ये क्लोज फ्रेंड्स है, तो अगर आए तो तीनों साथ में बैठते, कुछ भी कुछ ऑब्जेक्ट्स उनको दिए स्टोर करने के लिए, तो उन्हें क्या करते कि किनका बैग में उन्हें स्टोर कर लेता. तो एक का बैग छोटा है तो उन्हें कितना स्टोर कर सकता उतना ही स्टोर कर सकता, एक जना ज़्यादा स्टोर करता बिकॉज इसका बैग बड़ा है. तो लाइक दैट, सो ऑल दिस थ्री आर सिटिंग टुगेदर. द टोटल साइज इज 26 बाइट्स ओनली, बट rule number can store how much, what is the capacity of rule number? He can store up to 2 bytes of information. What is the capacity of name? Up to 20 bytes of information he can store. And what is the capacity percentage? 4 bytes. So everyone can store their data in their location only. The percentage information cannot be transferred to, suppose if I am storing other than more than 4 bytes of memory, that will not be okay stored in percentage. So these are very very important point you need to remember. Now the same thing I'm going to explain with the program. So once whatever the theoretical concepts I explained, that everything I will be explaining with the practical also. Hash include stdio.h. So next what I will do, hash include, so the time is very less, so what I will do, just exam point of view what we can write, that easy way program I'm explaining here. So void main I'm explaining. Now what I will do, I'll create a clr scr. Okay, so clearing the screen. So how to write here? Struct, what is the structure name? Student I'm writing. So what I will store in student, I want to store the name. Okay, name, rule number is what? Integer. So next semicolon, next I want to store the name. So it is your choice here, name. So suppose if I'm giving 15, means how many letters name you can store? 15 letters. If the student is having more than 15 letters name, it cannot accept, just it will take, even if you give 20 letters also, it will store only 15, the remaining 5 characters will be ignored. Okay, example like water tank, 1000 liter ka tank, ab motor se pani bhar rahe, kitne tak store kar sakte 1000, even 1000 se jyada store karenge bolke try kare to motor on karke laga to kya hota, overflow hota, jo uske andar kitna store kar sakte utna store kare, excess water ho to kya hota, overflow hota, wastage hota. So the same thing will be happened here. So now I want to store float percentage. Okay, percentage. Now structure is created. Now what I want to do, in order to store the values, I need to create a structure variable. How to create a structure variable? Okay, struct student s. What is s? S is a variable of student. What is student structure? Now can I say s is a student structure variable? What is the size of the structure? Kya hai? 2 plus 15 प्लस 4 कितना हो गया 19, 21 bytes. S का साइज कितना? 21 bytes. इन S how many values you can store? 3 values. One is in rule number and one is name and one is percentage. So 3 values you are storing in one variable, and all these 3 values are of different type. One is integer value, one is character, and one is float. So 3 different values you are storing in one variable. So that is the concept of this one. So at the time of creating only, so I'm not keeping the semicolon here. Now what is the definition of structure? Structure is a collection. So in mathematics, how to represent the collection? So if I'm writing 1, 2, 3, what is A? A is called as set. What is A? A is a set. A set is, what is the definition of set? A set is a well-defined collection of objects. So collection, how to represent collection? Floor bracket open and close. So this is called as collection. So I'm writing equal to, here I'm writing equal to, I'm writing 100, I'm writing in double quotation, I'm writing Anil, any name you can write, and here I'm writing 76.3. Now you tell me, what is 100? Rule number. What is the Anil? Name. what is 76.3%? Now these three values which I am storing in S. So internally in memory what will happen, one box will be created with how many bytes, 21 bytes ka memory ek block create hota. Ye block ke andar kitne pieces hote, 3 pieces hote, okay. To rule number yahan pe store hota, name yahan pe store hota, and percentage 76.3. So what is the name which is given to this box? S. So this is what is happening. So now you print the details. Now print the details, just whether the now rule number is equal to, what is rule number? Percentile D. Because why I am writing percentile D? Because rule number is which variable? Integer. To display any integer value, what is required? Format specifier. Which format specifier we are going to use? Integer format specifier is percentile D slash n. What is the meaning of slash n? New line. So next I'm taking name. I'm displaying the values now. Percentile S. Why I'm taking S? Because name na, name is nothing but string na. So S I'm taking. So next I'm taking what? Percentage. Percentage is equal to percentile F we have tried. So after this double quotation comma. So you tell me, okay. So just one simple example I'll ask. Suppose int a equal to 10 is there. Okay. You created one variable int a equal to. How to print the value now? Printf, printf. What you will write here? The value of a is equal to double percentile d. Okay, percentile d double quotation comma. What you write? A you write. I think this is clear to you. But now I cannot write directly what I will write here, rule number. So why? Because the rule number is not direct variable. Here the rule a is very direct variable, but rule number is a part of it, is a present in student structure. Ye mai bole so point acha observe karo. यहाँ पे int a बोलते एक नॉर्मल वेरिएबल है. डायरेक्ट वेरिएबल को आप क्या करें, प्रिंट द वैल्यू ऑफ a इक्वल परसेंटाइल डी कामा ये लिख दिए. मान यहाँ पे आप डायरेक्टली कामा, सो फर्स्ट परसेंटाइल विल रिप्रेजेंट रूल नंबर. तो आप क्या समझ रहे, रूल नंबर, ओके कामा. नेक्स्ट व्हाट यू राइट, नेम कामा, ओके एंड नेक्स्ट व्हाट, परसेंटेज. तो ऐसे लिखे तो कंपाइलर क्या करता, गेट सी एच, ओके एंड क्लोज. अगर ऐसा लिखे एरर आता, बिकॉज रूल नंबर डायरेक्ट रूल नंबर नहीं है, वो किसके अंदर है, स्टूडेंट स्ट्रक्चर के अंदर है. स्टूडेंट स्ट्रक्चर के अंदर जाके तो एस डॉट यू हैव टू से. सो हियर आल्सो एस डॉट यू हैव टू से, हियर आल्सो एस डॉट. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग, स्टोर द रूल नंबर, गेट द रूल नंबर विच इज स्टोर्ड इन एस, विच इज स्टोर्ड इन एस. व्हाट इज एस हियर, स्टूडेंट. इट विल गो टू वेयर, स्टूडेंट. इन साइड स्टूडेंट इन रूल नंबर व्हाट आर द वैल्यू विच इज स्टोर्ड, दैट विल बी डिस्प्लेड. तो समझ में आना, S dot we have to say rule number which is stored in S. What is S here? S is a structure variable. Which structure variable? Student. It will go to where? Student, and it will get the. So again I'm repeating, rule number is a value which is stored in S. So S ke andar rule number mein, ye rule number hai, ye name hai, ye theek hai, percentage hai. सो रूल नंबर किसका, रूल नंबर एस का. तो एस के अंदर रूल नंबर क्या है यहाँ पे, 100. तो 100 प्रिंट होता. सो प्लीज़ ये डायरेक्ट वेरिएबल को ए कामा बी कामा सी लिखते. मैं यहाँ पे स्ट्रक्चर का कभी भी लिखते, स्ट्रक्चर का वेरिएबल का नाम डॉट लगा के भूलाना. तो देन यू विल गेट द आंसर. सो आई थिंक द कॉन्सेप्ट इज क्लियर टू यू. द सेम थिंग आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग विद द प्रोग्राम, सो एवरीथिंग विल बी क्लियर. नाउ आई विल टेक टर्बोसी सॉफ्टवेयर and everything, the medical thing as a practical thing as a practical. So whatever the theoretical concept I said, so why? Because once the structure concept is clear, then we can understand the union concept. So both are interlinked topics. In final exam compulsory you'll get what is structure or what is union, or else you'll get a difference between structure and union. Compulsory one question you'll get in final exam for 8 months, okay. Now this is a program. So what I'm doing, so I'm doing the program now. So I am removing this because I am not going to use these concepts in program. So directly I am going to the void main. So after void main, what I will write here? CLR SER. So I will write, what I will write here? I will create a structure. Struct, okay, I will write student. Student, okay. So after this flower bracket open, what I want to do? I want to store the rule number of a student, okay. So after that I want to store the name of the student. Name. So how many bytes I am giving here? 15 or is your choice, 20 or any. So I want to store only 20. So I want to store percentage. So I will write here percentage, semicolon, close, and semicolon. So whenever you create a structure, structure will not get any memory space. When the structure will get a memory space, when you create a structure variable. How to create a structure variable? Struct, what I will write here? Student s we have to write. Okay. So at the time of creating only I want to store the values. So I'm storing different values now. So I'll give you 100. Okay, in double quotation I will write. So why? Because string can be represented in double quotation. So here I am writing Anil. So after that I will write percentage, comma, in double quotation I will write 89.7. So any value you can give. So we have to put a comma, 89.9 or some anything you can give, and close this and semicolon. Okay, clear na? Now just to print whether these values are stored or not. Okay, printf. Now what you will write? So just double quotation, you know already everything and all subjects concepts I explained. So just once watch the printf and scanf concept, so you come to know what is printf and concept. Okay, so I'm writing here rule number is equal to percentile d. Okay, now slash n, name is equal to slash n, sorry, name is equal to percentile s slash n, next percentage. So once you put semicolon, just compile the program and you see you'll get an error. So you're getting error because undefined symbol rule number, because it is not direct variable, it is available in student structure. So whenever you want to access any member of your structure, we have to write s dot. We have to take the permission of structure. Okay, so s dot, because that is not direct variable, it is a part of structure. So again you compile the program. Now you see you are not getting any error and warning, just you see. And so rule number 100 and name is Anil and percentage is 89.9. So I think everything is clear to you. So and I want to show you one important point. So what is the memory size of the structure? So how to find the memory size? You know how to find the memory size of operator. So memory, just I'm writing memory size of, okay, s is equal to, so memory size always integer value. So what I will add here, size of s. Okay, simple, just compile the program and execute the program and you can come to know. See here, the memory size of the structure is 21 bytes you are getting. Is it right or wrong? So if you are getting slash n, I will put here, so we will get a clarity, slash n. So again I am compiling, just you can see the observed output. So the memory size of structure s is equal to 21. So how count it now? How count it? Just along with me count it now. Rule number, okay. So rule number means what? Rule number is 2 bytes and the name is 15. 2 plus 15, 17. Float means 4 bytes. Total 17 plus 4, 21 marks. So even if I give here 20, so if I write here 20, if I write 20, what is the memory size here? 26 bytes. Just check it once, compile the program and execute the program and we are getting what? The memory size of S is 26 bytes. So it means, so in C language, in predefined data type, every variable is having fixed size, but when you go to the concept of structure, so the increase in the size or decrease in size, it depends upon the number of members. So I think the concept is clear to you. The next video will be union video. Okay, so please subscribe my channel Anu Computer Education to get further updates. I think the concept is clear to you. Okay, thank you. Please use the comment section and please comment on the comment section. So I hope this video, you like this video. Thank you.